we're seeing erosion that we've never seen before.
That is water coming from underneath the roadway.
Built in the 30s by the Works Progress Administration, the road Mount Scott was well constructed. But over time, storm after rainstorm, Lynn Cartmell with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service says it's taken a beating.
This is a 24-inch culvert.
It was not one specific day. It was most likely a culmination of multiple events, although there could have been one event like the 2015 flood that could have caused more damage than others.
A view from Storm Commander 360 Cam. Notice that we're driving on the wrong side of the road. Yeah, because it's the inside lane. That's where the damage is. It's not that visual, but that's the erosion. It's underneath the road.
It's really interesting. This whole slope here becomes a giant waterfall. So it's waterfalls every time you have a cliffway.
I imagine during a rainstorm, that's a river coming down, going down there, and then eroding away the road.
Where it hits right here. How it's starting to pull out those gaps. So these areas would have been lined with a rock. And you can see that that rock has been completely moved.
The largest hole is probably 36 feet long, and it at its deepest point is somewhere between 5 to 6 feet deep.
5 to 6 feet deep as in under the road, right?
Underneath the road.
Yeah, that wouldn't be good if you drove over that.
Here we are, the top of Mount Scott. Usually that parking lot is filled with cars. That is not gonna happen until the road is fixed. That could take a while. Your only way to the top, you can walk, run, or bike up.
We do have a contractor selected. They're in the process of generating some geotechnical reports. Once that's complete, they'll start the engineering plan.
This is no easy fix. It is going to take time. But the rangers of Mount Scott are optimistic.
We're hoping to see it open by the end of the year.
The Wichita Wildlife Refuge has more to offer than just a drive up to the top of Mount Scott. There is camping, hiking, and fishing.
And we know that everyone's frustrated. We know that Mount Scott is a resource that they like to use. But there's so much more to experience, and we encourage them to get out and find something new, something that they haven't seen before.
Reporting on Mount Scott, meteorologist Jonathan Conder, KOCO 5 News.